What?
Boy, I don't think they're ready for this.
These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. Pull up on them and it look nice, look nice.
These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future.
Yeah, we look nice, future looking nice. We don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
Yeah, we look nice, future looking real nice. We don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
Hello and welcome to Netstrata Jubilee Stadium here in the south of Sydney. You may just be able to hear alarm bells ringing. Sydney FC versus Wellington Phoenix. And there is plenty at stake in this final match of round 5 of the A-League men's competition, the Australian First Division. And Sydney FC sitting in a very unfamiliar position of second from bottom after 4 matches. There is plenty on the line. Both coaches, Ufuk Talay, who of course played and coached at Sydney FC, now at the helm of Wellington Phoenix. His side come into this round of matches sitting 9th, having lost their last 2. They need something special as well. There is no lack of motivation between these two sides to get the points. Steve Corica has seen his side score in just 1 match so far this season. Here they come onto the pitch, our two sides at this Netstrata Stadium. It's been a very, very warm and muggy day in Sydney, but the mercury is plummeting after reaching 33, 34 degrees. There's even a bit of rain about now in a subtropical Sydney as we have a look at Steve Corica's side. 3 changes from the team that lost 2-0 to the Central Coast Mariners. Bobo makes way up front for Elvis Kamsoba, who returns to the starting 11. There's a first ever start in the middle of the park for Patrick Yazbek, who comes in for Ninkovic. That sees Anthony Caceres move out into a wide position. And James Donaghy, likewise the central defender, comes in for his first start of the A-League season. He has started in the Cup. It was his goal that broke the deadlock in extra time against the MacArthur Bulls that qualified Sydney for the quarterfinals of that competition. They take on the Roar on Wednesday in the quarters, while for Wellington Phoenix, they are also getting plenty of joy in the FFA Cup. Just 1 change from the side that defeated Avondale 4-1 in midweek. It comes in midfield with the experienced Clayton Lewis coming in to replace Nick Pennington in the middle of the park. 1 change from that midweek result, however. 4 changes from the side that lost 4-0 to the Jets just a week ago, in which a result that was Ufuk Talay's worst ever result as coach of Wellington Phoenix. It's Sydney FC that get us underway. These two sides have been misfiring in attack. Sydney FC, amazingly, still looking for their first win of the season, 5 matches in. I'm joined by Daniel McBreen. Macca, I get the feeling there could be goals in this one.
Well, I'm sure both coaches are hoping there's goals, but at the right end. Both struggled so far, both conceding goals, and they're looking for a reaction.
We have two sides that like to pass the ball around, that like to play aggressive football. Sotirio picks up the first foul. He's an important piece of the puzzle for Ufuk Talay's side this afternoon. And that was something on there for Sydney. It's Yazbek who slides in and gets it to Retre. Kamsoba's touch back for Caceres, who hits it, and Adam Lafondra almost got a telling deviation on that one. First half chance of the match for Sydney, but you can see there was an opening that they didn't take. They had to rebuild.
Yeah, it was initially a sloppy touch from Lafondra, and it looked promising move going out to the left-hand side. But as it came back in, this is Lafondra. Look at him again. He goes again, and that's the sign of a great striker, looking to get back into that box, into the danger area. Anything that comes across, you stick that leg out. Couldn't quite get control of it this time.
Sydney looking to take full advantage. Rufa flying in, but now Kamsoba, who was sitting nicely for the strike, invitingly. Then on the left boot, Kamsoba on target in the 10th minute, saved by Ollie Sale.
there probably is a player that they're looking for too, someone who can really spark something.
There's Caceres into the area, space, finds Cam Soba. And that was a second very presentable opportunity for Elvis Cam Soba.
Well, we spoke in the pre-game about consistency in the final product, and it was well worked down this right-hand side, Caceres making the forward run. And they have the numbers, so he gets the drive into the box, and you see Cam Soba around the penalty spot. He has to be hitting the target from there. Caceres has done everything right, took his time, had a look, drove inside, committed the first defender, lays it on a platter. And Cam Soba, he must hit the target, and that's what we were talking about there. You score that goal there, you change the whole complexion, the confidence of the team.
Now Sydney can press forward again. Burgess. Burgess still, he's looking for options, looking for movement. Retre, now the cross in from King is not a bad one. Van der Sar, now Cam Soba. Is this the opportunity? It is. And Elvis Cam Soba has Sydney in front. 19 minutes gone.
Well, for a moment, it looked like it was all dead and buried and the ball looked like it was going to roll out over the byline. But Sydney have seen, I think, Joel King down the left-hand side. As we see here, as the ball goes by, it looks like it's got away from him, but he does wonderfully well to get it back. And the Wellington defence sleeping as Cam Soba slips it at the back step. This time, composes himself, takes a touch. And the Harvey Norman replay will show it right here. Composure, gets it down, picks his spot, nails it in that beer post area. And that's what we were talking about. The composure in those areas, you hit the target, straight into the near post. 1-0 to Sydney.
Just too hot to handle for Ollie Sale.
Yeah, young Alexander Paulson, just 19 years of age, makes his debut for the Wellington Phoenix. You just noticed the last goal kick, Ollie Sale didn't take it. Tim Payne didn't quite pick up when he did his injury, but he was limping for the last 5 minutes or so and had a chat to Ufuk Tele and immediately asked the young goalkeeper to get ready to come on. So big moment for the 19-year-old.
Payne with Rufa. This is one thing Phoenix can do to try and get back into the game is just have a period of possession, try and hold on to the ball.
Well, they haven't really had one, have they? Not a sustained period. We know that they are quality, and we see here.
Sotirio with a devilish strike bouncing just in front of Redmayne.
Don't mind the strike from there, but there's overlapping runs on the right. Just think, a little bit of sustained ball pressure. If you look here, it's probably a little bit too tight, but it's going to take something really special to beat Redmayne from that area.
Can Sydney transition quickly with Burgess? King arriving as Burgess strikes. Paulson can't claim it. Parries it out into a dangerous area. Caceres going down, looking towards the referee.
I guess probably coming off the back of last week's performance, it'd be a bit more like, let's consolidate. Let's not make sure our structures are good. Okay, they've conceded a goal, but let's make sure we don't concede another early.
It's a clever little touch from Lafondra for Cam Soba. And a first save of an A-League career for Alexander Paulson. Good one at his near post.
Well, it was a lovely little touch inside, wasn't it? Lafondra, the flick, and Cam Soba takes off, first touch. Deflected shot as it comes in. So great save on the near post for Paulson. And that touch there from Lafondra was quality. Probably just a little heavy on the touch from Cam Soba. Left him stretching for the shot.
After rain threatened at kickoff, Rentre's ball. It's a good ball into the danger zone. The follower! Oh, was that the youngster Yazbek?
I think it might have been Rentre. Oh, it was Yazbek, you're right. Well spotted, Robbie.
Fantastic shot and a great save. But probably in your first game, you want to be able to make a couple of saves, don't you?
Definitely, definitely. Confidence builder. It's three saves now. All probably saves that were in the nice area for him. It's good confidence builders, but he's dealt with them all.
Good performance as well. And you're looking for positives from Patrick Yazbek. This is Cam Sober. For the outrageous. The showman. What was Cam Sober? It was going to take something extra special to score there.
30 seconds left in the half. It's popped up. Why not have a crack?
Youngster in goal.
Yeah. Goes in, makes highlights around the world. Got some good elevation, but no direction.
Is there one last chance in this opening half of football? Sydney are just bossing it in the middle of the park as Wayne, a tackle of frustration on Caceres as he heads immediately down the tunnel. And Wellington Phoenix, some frowns and gloomy faces heading down the tunnel there. Not the case for Sydney FC. Well, Elvis Cam Sober's 19th minute goal, his second of the season, separates the two sides here at Netstrata Jubilee Stadium. At Sydney FC 1, Wellington Phoenix 0. Futale screaming for everyone to step forward as soon as they force Sydney back. Force them into that long ball. The 50-50 challenge at the back, won by Payne again. But they have to stay organised at the back as Caceres drives through the heart. Oh, and his pack finds Lafondra. And he has driven a dagger through Wellington Phoenix there. On the counter-attack, Sydney have their second goal. And just as it was against the Jets, the only other time they scored, it's Cam Sober and Lafondra on the score sheet.
Well, again, as we see the Harvey Norman replay, Anthony Caceres picks the ball up and drives. And as the defence comes close, he plays that ball. He actually underhits it. And Sam Sutton should clear the pass. You see, just underhits the pass here. Sam Sutton should clear. But Lafondra, we said, if he gets his opportunities, he will score. And there he has his opportunity. As it comes, just takes his touch forward. And a class finisher. We see his usual celebration. Stevie Corico, extremely excited, but it looks more like relief from Adam Lafondra.
Ball for Sutton. Piscopo dancing away from challenges into the area. He's done well, deflected behind and corner to follow.
Sam Sutton looking to get forward down that left-hand side. So Lewis there picking the pass. Then Piscopo weaving his magic, trying to get around two Sydney defenders. It's going to be difficult. And that's something you want. When you're up, you know, low on confidence, struggling, you need some one or two of your players really to stand up and lay a marker down and show some aggression, really try to fire someone up. Doesn't mean you have to go out and hurt someone or foul them.
The ball from Burgess to the back post. Van der Sarg. Piscopo back helping out. Good thing he was too. And he goes again. They've won it back. Cam Sober now. Caceres in the area. Oh, lovely skill. Almost a wonderful goal. How about that with the sole
Ryan,
of the foot?
Ryan's first. Robbie.
We're going to have a change. I can hear the name Ryan. Was that Ryan Grant to come in, perhaps?
See the replay here. It's Anthony Caceres at his best. Finish not up to his standard. Lovely feet in tight areas. Little dinky. Shakes it back from one foot to the other. And again, talk about Sydney FC's finishing. He needs to hit the target there. You see multiple changes.
That's a triple change coming. Experience. Nearly 100 years combined age there. I mean this all in a very positive sense. 36-year-olds Ninkovic and Bubu coming on. Ryan Grant also into the contest. The Australia international Ryan Grant, who comes in at the veritably young 30 years of age. And Sunset's just getting better and better, Macca. Ball back post, and the header from Wayne, I think it was. There's Miloš Ninković. You're never going to be that worse off when you bring him onto the pitch, are you? A double change now for Phoenix, who look to midfield to try and turn things around. We built him up, Josh Sotirio, and he struggled to really get into the contest. Ben Old comes in now. He's a player with a big future. Retreat. Clever run from Ninković. Good ball as well. Kamsobo, he's done brilliantly. Into the area, Kamsoba's cross to the back post. And I think it just took a touch off someone to foil Bobo.
Well, he looked bemused, Bobo, didn't he? Where did it go? Must have got a touch just in front of him and took it out of his eye line. For all money, you thought it was going to be tapping that into a net.
That's well played by Casera. Strong, just brushing away Piscopo. Good switch of play. Should have hit the target there. Joel King, it was a very good sighting on goal.
It was again wonderful play from Ninković. Kamsoba not on the same page, but fights well. Once he gets on an inside position here, you can see just a touch.
Is it through the legs?
I think it went through the legs, yeah. I believe it was Josh Laws that just got the touch, took it away from Bobo.
Bobo. Oh, it's a fantastic pass. Grant's cutback. Well, he had Kamsoba in the middle. He went looking for Caceres. It could so easily have been three, and what a goal it would have been. Get the feeling, and I know it's not easy when you're down 2-0 away from home, and here's Kamsoba again. A little touchback for Retreat. But when you're always reacting to every pass, you're starting behind the eight ball and you just get further and further behind.
You do, and that comes with confidence as well. And Sydney's second goal really kills off the momentum. Wellington had started the second half quite brightly, both with the ball and without the ball, pressing higher.
Ball comes off. And it's an A-League debut for Oscar Van Hattem. And it's good to see them getting their chance. Here he is, the first touch of the football in A-League men. That's a fair touch of the football as well. He finds Wayne, goes again. Wayne on the left foot, trying to bend it. Never looked like it was coming around enough. More positive stuff, and great to see a youngster, when they come into the game like that, not be overawed, just go for it.
Yeah, and that's what you want, positive play. Go and enjoy it. Anything you can provide, an assist, a goal, maybe it could be a bonus. Go out there, try and inject something, some positivity into the game.
Speaking of youngsters who have done well on debut, it's not exactly his debut, but look at that from Stevie Corica and his coaching staff. Well done, young man.
Fantastic performance. Esbeck came in. Was really assertive and dominant in that midfield. Looked like a player who'd been there for a while. Did not look out of place at all. Very proud of his first start in the A-League.
Oh, the header was not bad from Ben Wayne, and a fantastic save from Redmayne.
Almost came out of nothing. Nice ball whipped in. See time on the ball for once for Wellington, and just coming back, strain those neck muscles, and Redmayne force into a save. It's one of the only times we've seen Piscopo with time to get his head up and get across in.
Ben Wayne, the number 18, has the ball in, this time claimed by Redmayne. Buhadja comes into the contest to replace Kamsoba. Big round of applause for both players. They're looking for four victories in a row over Wellington Phoenix now. And most importantly, the first win of the season. It's the foul by King. Manhattan earns the free kick. Now Piscopo, we've seen he can deliver. In it comes, it's a good ball as well, but Sydney and Wilkinson willing again. Is this the chance? Through the legs. Well, they're going to have to check it. I think that looked very, very close indeed.
Yeah, when you see the defensive line going out and the attackers going in, it's going to be close. Ben Wayne, I think he believes he was onside, and Alex Wilkinson there saying, I don't know.
Well, that's fair enough as well. He's not offside, if that's the moment of contact.
No, he's onside.
He's on. There's no interference from the other players. There's the path. He's onside. And that should stand. And Wellington will have 10 minutes to throw the kitchen sink at Sydney FC.
Well, let's be honest. They didn't look like scoring a goal for a long time in this game. Now it would appear that they're going to have one, and it's going to make an interesting last 7 or so minutes.
And having just declared that it's a goal, we have to be careful that that angle is not exactly right, and these are not the VAR cameras. And that the referees are doing their job to make sure that they get this one right. Redmayne spread himself. He almost got the save. Here comes the decision, I think, from the referee, Ben Abraham. And the goal stands. So we got that one right as well. There it is, his first A-League goal of the season. I was just talking about his cup heroics, Ben Wayne. Now he's on the score sheet in the A-League men, replacing Gary Hooper, who's back in England for personal reasons. It's a good finish.
Yeah, it is a good finish. Under pressure. As Redmayne, you know he's going to be a big spread out behind you. A little sloppy Sydney defence going out, but not really marking as they go. And it's game on.
Retreat with Grant again. Nieuwenhof. He's been robbed of possession by Pennington. 3-on-3 as Sydney comes streaming back to defend. On this right-hand side, ball into Old. The little touch back and the shot deflected. They had numbers forward. It's good from Wellington, but it's not enough, not yet. Caceres with Rettray. They've done that well. Caceres into the box. The little lay back for Ninkovic to hit the target. He hits the post instead. And Phoenix live again. Oh, and the pass can't find the target. See Ninkovic lining up that shot. He hit it true. It was so close to a third goal, but it doesn't matter for Sydney FC, who have, at last, at the fifth time of asking, the first victory of this A-League season. But it's three losses on the trot now for Phoenix. Sydney steady their ship. The first 3 points for them. As it finishes at Netstrata Jubilee Stadium, the Sky Blue 2, the Knicks 1.